Hello everyone, I'm Wang Ning, a faculty from Northeastern University and also a member of Castle Research Group. Today, I would like to present our paper entitled Watchman, Monitoring Dependency Conflicts for Python Library Ecosystem. Python projects are commonly shared as third-party libraries in a server side-side repository PyPI and reused by many other projects. By May 2020, the PyPI ecosystem has indexed over 1.8 million Python libraries. This is a common development scenario of Python projects. Most of dependencies are stored in the PyPI ecosystem. The build process and dependency management are automatically implemented by combining a server-side repository and client-side library installer PIP. To be more specific, the local environment should pre-install the Python toolchains or may locally pre-install some libraries if needed. In a project's configuration script, developers should specify all their required third-party libraries with their corresponding compatible version constraints. With the aid of such configurations and library installer PIP, all the specified direct and transitive dependencies can be automatically downloaded and install it. The installed library version is the latest version satisfying the version constraints. As we can see, in a Python project, there are two types of dependencies, that is the local and remote dependency. And the version constraint mechanism enables automatic self-evolution of the remote dependencies. In addition, for Python projects, all its specified direct and transitive dependencies are called its upstream projects, and the projects depending on it are called its downstream projects. So that among the complex dependency relationships in the PyPI ecosystem, such automatic building comes with the risk of potential dependency conflict issues. In the Python world, if the same library with different version constraints are introduced in a project, according to PIP's installation rule, only the first found library can be installed. PIP adopts breadth-first traversal strategy to install the libraries. So if the installed version of a library violates its other version constraint on the same dependence tree of a project, then a build error will happen. However, the real-world bugs are far more complicated in the open-source community. Taking the issue reports in project channels as an example, the project's channels version 2.1.7 directly depends on two libraries, Sgrave and Daphne. Before April 9, 2019, there are no dependency conflict issues. However, with the evolution of the libraries, the project Daphne released a newer version 2.3.0, which can be installed in the project's channels. So here comes the question. The newer version of Daphne introduce the library Sgrave again with a conflicting version constraint, causing a build error in project channels. To address this issue, channels developers revised the version constraint of the library Sgrave in a fixed version. But the story is not over. After April 14, 2019, the fixed version of channels also affected downstream project channels Redis, causing another dependency conflict issue. In fact, this real easy issue is only a tip of the iceberg in the Python ecosystem. Developers' complaints about dependency conflicts can be seen everywhere in the open source community. Because lack of a global view of the version constraint among large number of Python projects, developers complained that some library version constraints only can specifically work in their own project or only can work on their own machine by causing more conflicts in many other projects. From the comments, we can observe these two obvious challenges. The version of library installed for Python projects can evolve over time. When library updates its version constraint on its depending libraries, its downstream projects could be affected. What's more, the state-of-the-art tools like PipEv or Poetry and so on only can show which libraries have been installed, rather than the full dependency graphs. So the developers are looking for the effective tools or techniques that can help them generate full dependency graphs for their Python projects when diagnosing the DC issues. As such, there exists a third challenge. It is difficult to obtain a full dependency graph with version constraints for projects on PyPI. To address these three challenges and help developers combat these issues, in our work, we first conducted empirical study to understand the characteristic of these issues. The distilled common patterns enables automatic diagnosis. We also investigated how developers fix dependency conflicts in their Python projects and summarized common fixing strategies. Furthermore, we propose a technique watchman. It can perform holistic analysis from the perspective of the entire PyPI ecosystem to continuously monitor and detect dependency conflicts caused by the daily library updates. Finally, we evaluated our approach based on collection of open source projects. By analyzing our collected issue reports, we divided these issues into two patterns, according to whether the issue is caused by remote dependency updates or affected by the local environment. For each issue pattern, they can be further characterized based on where the dependency conflicts come from, that is, the conflicts between direct and transitive dependencies, conflicts between transitive dependencies. Based on our empirical findings, we propose a technique watchman. It first constructs a metadata repository for all the libraries courses on PyPI to enable the analysis of interference between version constraints across downstream and upstream projects. Then, by continuously monitoring the library release information on PyPI, it synchronously updates the metadata repository to precisely model the dependency relationships. For the captured library updates, Watchman identifies all the potentially affected downstream projects based on PIP's installation rules. Finally, it performs automatic DC issue diagnosis. To summarize, the main features of our Watchman include performing a holistic analysis for the entire PyPI ecosystem, simulating the process of installing dependencies, submitting the issue reports and PRs automatically, and providing self-diagnosis service. To evaluate the effectiveness of our watchman, we play back the evolution history of all the libraries on PyPI in the past 5 years, and use the resolving repeal and lasting time as the metrics. For the predicted issues, we also checked whether they had turned into the real ones. Our obtained satisfactory results strongly demonstrate that our watchman can precisely detect and predict these issues. We also deployed Watchman to monitor the PyPI libraries and evaluate its usefulness based on developers' feedbacks. In total, Watchman detected and predicted 279 real DC issues during the following 2 periods and achieved high confirmation and fixing rates. All the daily library updates information on PyPI captured by Watchman and our detected real DC issues are released on our website. Besides, we also obtained several positive feedbacks from developers. For example, they said that using a bot like Watchman to inform the potential dependency conflict issues on GitHub is the best solution for Python projects. Such a mechanism of maintaining the rationality of dependency constraints among the projects in PyPI is much needed. Recently, we also promoted Watchman in the open source community by communicating with developers. For research purpose, we recorded how visitors interact with the Watchman website from December 2019 to January 2020. Altogether, Watchman has generated diagnosis issue reports for 2,590 Python projects. Global statistics demonstrate that the real-world developers show great interest in our proposed technique. And we also warmly welcome more researchers and Python developers to try out and test our tool, Watchman. That's all for my presentation. Thank you very much for your attention.